All right, Laura, now we are going to talk about penetration testing. A penetration test normally uses the same methods a hacker uses to gain unauthorized access to a network or system with a view to compromise them. The purpose of a penetration test is to test the security implementations and policy of an organization. The goal of this testing is to see if the organization has implemented security measures as specified in the security policy.
That's correct. And a hacker whose intent is to gain unauthorized access to an organization's network is different from a professional penetration tester. The professional tester does not have malicious intent and uses his or her skills to improve an organization's network security without causing a loss of service or disruption to the business. The only difference between true hacking and pen testing is permission. It is critical that a person performing a penetration test get written consent to perform the test.
And then when you get that consent, you can wear the white hat.
Correct.
So let's elaborate further on penetration testing. We're going to start with the types of penetration testing that are out there. External penetration testing is the conventional approach to penetration testing. This testing is focused on the server's infrastructure and underlying software pertaining to the actual target. It can be performed with no prior knowledge of the site or with full disclosure of the topology and the environment.
Mm-hmm. Now, internal testing makes use of similar methods as the external testing and is considered to be a more versatile view of the security. Testing will be performed from several network access points, including both logical and physical segments. It is important to note that penetration testing only gives a snapshot of the security posture of an organization at any given point in time. Internal testing will be performed from a number of network access points, representing each logical and physical segment.
Right. So, what do you get from this? Well, like you said, Laura, you get a snapshot. It is relevant at that point only. Now, any changes to your software, hardware, network composition, and configuration can necessitate a retest. Mm-hmm. Hope you got that point. Now, let's talk about black box testing. In black box testing, a pen tester carries out the test without having any prior knowledge of the target. In order to simulate real-world attacks and minimize false positives, pen testers can choose to undertake black hat testing or a zero-knowledge attack with no information or assistance from the client, and then map the network while enumerating services, shared file systems, and operating systems discreetly. Additionally, the pen tester can undertake war dialing to detect listening modems and war driving to discover vulnerable access points if it is legal and within the scope of the project.
Mm-hmm. In gray box penetration testing, the test is conducted with limited knowledge about infrastructure, defense mechanisms, and communication channels of the target on which the test is to be conducted. It is a simulation of those attacks that is performed by the insider or outsider with limited access or privileges. In this case, organizations would prefer to provide the pen testers with partial knowledge or information that hackers could find, such as a domain name server. This it can save the organization time and expense. In gray box testing, pen testers may also interact with system and network administrators.
All right, so we talked about black box, we talked about gray box. It is now time to talk about white box testing. It's the other extreme of pen testing. In white box penetration testing, the test is conducted with full knowledge of infrastructure, defense mechanisms, and communication channels of the target on which the test is being conducted. Now, this test simulates the insider attacker who has full privileges, maybe somebody who works within the organization, unlimited access to that target system.
Yes. And we have explained about types of pen tests. We also explained about which type of tester corresponds to each type of pen test. Now, let me compare and contrast pen testing with hackers. A black hat test is done with little or no information about the system to be tested. A black hat hacker has a malicious intent and is not publicly known.
Otherwise known as the bad guys. Mm-hmm. Gray box testing is carried out by ethical hackers, and they are given some information about the system and network. A gray hat hacker is a skilled hacker who hacks a system, software, or network, but will not cause damage. He or she acts mostly for offensive purposes, sometimes in goodwill, and sometimes for defensive purposes. White hat testing is carried out with all the information about the target. Full disclosure, a white hat hacker always tests for a good purpose.
That's correct. Now let's compare and contrast hackers and penetration testers. A hacker will not have any code of ethics, whereas a penetration tester follows a strict code of ethics. A penetration tester has authorization before testing, whereas a hacker will attack stealthily and will not be known unless detected.
That's right. And a hacker will follow any technique or means to achieve his or her goals, right? A penetration tester confines himself or herself to a defined boundary. A hacker attempts to bypass the log so that the attacks can go unnoticed, and a penetration tester logs all activity. In fact, a penetration tester submits all logs and reports to the organization. There's analysis involved.
Mm-hmm. A hacker works to exploit the vulnerabilities, whereas a penetration tester tries to identify the vulnerabilities to get them fixed. Just to summarize, a hacker is a bad guy working for his own benefit, and a penetration tester is a good guy working for the benefit of the organization.
Right. So we have covered the basics of penetration testing and pen testers. Mm-hmm. Now it's time for a brief explanation of penetration testing methodology. The methodology has the following steps. You ready?
Yes.
Footprinting, scanning, enumeration, and penetration. We will explain each and every one of these.
Right. Footprinting is the process of creating a blueprint or a map of an organization's network and systems. Footprinting begins by determining the target system, application, or physical location of the target. Specific information about the organization is gathered using non-intrusive methods. The information the hacker is looking for during the footprinting phase is anything that gives clues as to the network architecture, server, application types, where valuable data is stored.